Hello and welcome. I'm Todd Erpelding, Medical Affairs Leader at Canon Medical, and I'm here today with my colleague, Tammy Logan. We're going to show you the liver analysis package on the Canon Aplio i800, our ultra-premium ultrasound system with outstanding workflow, ergonomics, and innovative imaging technologies. Liver disease has become a global burden and a major health concern. In fact, more than 80 million Americans are afflicted with some form of chronic liver disease. Many of these patients have viral liver diseases like hepatitis B or C, or fatty liver disease. The growth of fatty liver disease, particularly non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, or NAFLD, is especially alarming. That growth is being driven by the increasing prevalence of obesity and type 2 diabetes. The management of fatty liver disease is a clinical challenge, as it can be a slowly progressing disease with various clinical factors involved, from steatosis, inflammation, fibrosis, and cirrhosis. Patients may require long follow-up, and the current standard of care for assessment of liver disease is often biopsy, a painful and invasive procedure. Clinicians and patients need better options. A non-invasive, validated, and economical test that can be used in early detection, staging, and therapy monitoring of liver disease is clearly needed. So at Canon, we've developed a comprehensive suite of ultrasound tools that can help with the diagnosis and monitoring of patients with liver disease. Let me tell you a little bit more about the Aplio i-Series liver analysis package. When you look at the progression of NAFLD, the earliest stages start with fatty infiltration or simple steatosis, which often goes undetected. Some patients are at risk for inflammation and fibrosis, leading to a more advanced stage of fatty liver disease called non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, or NASH, which can involve liver cirrhosis and perhaps liver cancer. Fortunately, ultrasound has a number of quantitative tools to help in the diagnosis of liver disease. For patients at risk of liver cancer, contrast-enhanced ultrasound can be useful for the characterization of liver lesions, both in adult and pediatric patients. With the Aplio i-Series, we also offer a robust quantification software to quantify the time intensity curve from microbubble contrast agent accumulation within focal liver lesions. For liver fibrosis or cirrhosis, shear wave elastography can be a useful non-invasive tool for accurate and reproducible assessment of fibrosis in patients with liver disease. But for the earlier stages of liver disease, particularly steatosis and inflammation, ultrasound has lacked the diagnostic capabilities for quantitative assessment. That's where Canon's unique suite of liver analysis tools, including not just shear wave elastography, but shear wave dispersion and attenuation imaging, that can be used as an aid in the diagnosis and monitoring of patients with NAFLD and NASH. Shear wave dispersion, Canon's unique enhancement of conventional shear wave, displays and quantifies the shear wave dispersion slope, which is related to liver viscosity. Recent studies suggest that the dispersion slope can help provide a quantitative, non-invasive assessment of lobular inflammation in patients with NAFLD and NASH. Last but not least is our attenuation imaging, which is a reliable and accurate tool for the assessment of hepatic steatosis. It's well understood that a fatty liver is more attenuating, and now clinicians have an imaging method to detect and quantify attenuation in patients with steatosis. So let's move to the Aplio i800 system and look at some live scanning. While scanning today, Tammy will be using an ultra-wideband matrix array transducer, the i8CX1. This transducer utilizes Canon's intelligent dynamic microslice, or IDMS matrix technology, to control the firing of individual transducer elements in the lens direction, which creates a thin slice beam giving great detail from skin line to the far field. So let's start with liver shear wave. To begin, the patient should be placed in a supine or slight left lateral decubitus position with the right arm reached over the head. We'll be scanning the right lobe of the liver in an intercostal acoustic window, taking care to avoid shadow artifacts and large vessels in the portal trunk. Once you've found a good window, the shear wave function is easily launched by pressing the SWE button from the touchscreen. The Shearwave ROI appears outlined in green and should be placed in the center of the image, approximately 1 centimeter below the liver capsule. Now, when you're ready to acquire, ask the patient to suspend breathing mid-respiration and press the one-shot button next to the trackball. As you can see, the measurement ROI automatically appears, and the shear wave speed and propagation map are displayed in twin view. On the left-hand side is the shear wave speed map, and you can see in this patient that the deep blue colors indicating a slow shear wave speed in meters per second, which is consistent with a patient with a normal, healthy liver. On the right-hand side is our propagation map, and that's Canon's unique offering to help assess the quality of the shear wave acquisition and help guide the placement of your measurement sample. Look for smooth, parallel propagation lines when setting your ROI. When the image is stored, the measurement result is automatically entered into the Shearwave worksheet. Great job. Thanks, Tammy. Next, we'd like to show you attenuation imaging. Conventional methods for ultrasound assessment of hepatic steatosis are largely qualitative and subjective, such as comparing the brightness of liver and kidney. With attenuation imaging, we have a reliable and accurate tool for the assessment of liver steatosis that is real-time, fast, and easy to use. Recent studies have shown that the attenuation coefficient can be a valuable biomarker for detecting and quantifying liver steatosis, including mild steatosis, as compared to histopathology or MRI proton density fat fraction, PDFF. Let's take a look at how this works. As you can see, attenuation imaging is a real-time imaging mode, and it can be displayed in twin view. It displays and quantifies the attenuation coefficient in units of dB per centimeter megahertz. Scan the right lobe of the liver with an intercostal window, just as we demonstrated with Shearwave. On the left is your conventional grayscale image, and on the right is the attenuation color map overlaid on the grayscale image. Orange indicates higher attenuation coefficients, and the greens and the blues indicate areas with lower attenuation coefficient. Vessels and echogenic structures are automatically excluded from the color map, enabling you to easily assess the liver parenchyma. When you're ready to quantify the attenuation imaging results, simply press the freeze button, and your measurement ROI box will automatically appear. Place the measurement sample, avoiding large vessels, artifacts in the subcapsular region, and areas of weak signal. Attenuation imaging can be performed quickly and easily, often only needing 1 to 2 minutes to complete your assessment for liver steatosis. And the great news is that now we can offer attenuation imaging on both the Apleo I-Series and Apleo A-Series systems. Thanks, Tammy. So at Canon, we recognize that sonographers are often challenged by doing more exams in less time, and workflow is becoming increasingly important. For the quantitative liver analysis tools, we've created a streamlined workflow that allows for simultaneous acquisition of shear wave elastography, shear wave dispersion, and attenuation imaging results. Let's take a look at how it works. We've incorporated this simultaneous capture and quantification of all three liver analysis parameters into our conventional shear wave elastography mode. As we showed before, when you launch Shearwave elastography, you'll place your green ROI appropriately in the right lobe of the liver. Now, when Tammy acquires her Shearwave result with our one-shot acquisition, you can display the Shearwave speed map side by side with the attenuation imaging result, giving clinicians the ability to assess hepatic fibrosis and steatosis in a single view. We've also taken it one step further with our quad view display, which can show Shearwave speed, attenuation imaging, and shear wave dispersion results simultaneously alongside the propagation map. Now clinicians can quantify all three parameters in a single acquisition with an optimized workflow. Now let's take a look at how we summarize the quantitative liver analysis results. Here's our multiparametric report, which provides a concise summary of all your liver analysis results, shear wave elastography and shear wave dispersion, attenuation imaging, and the associated statistical values like median and IQR to median ratio. In the upper right corner, we have our unique slider display. So the current patient results can be displayed on a customized scale, which can be adapted based on the latest published studies and guidelines, including the recent Rule of Four recommendation from the Society of Radiologists and Ultrasound, or SRU, which highlights the current best practices for interpretation of liver stiffness in patients with viral hepatitis and NAFLD. With the multiparametric report, you can quickly see where the current patient's shear wave results lie in terms of the Rule of Four on a scale of 5, 9, 13, and 17 kPa. The multiparametric report can also be customized to incorporate clinical information, such as BMI or lab values, for a more comprehensive assessment of the patient's liver health in a simple and concise snapshot. Here, as you can see, we've added AST and ALT lab values to the multiparametric report, and those can be displayed at the same time as your quantitative imaging findings for shear wave dispersion, and attenuation imaging. So I hope you've enjoyed today's demonstration of Canon's liver analysis package. The power of the Aplio iSeries platform enables a streamlined workflow for getting additional quantitative information so you can better assess the liver health in patients with chronic liver disease. Now we have time for Q&A. Please feel free to type in your questions. I'll be happy to answer and share a little more about the Aplio iSeries. Okay, so I see a question. Can you delete shear wave measurements from the worksheet? Well, thank you for the question. So good news is yes, from the shear wave worksheet, we do have a checkbox that can be unchecked if you'd like to remove outlier measurements from your shear wave report. And the statistics will update once you've unchecked those outlier measurements. Okay, next question. Can you replace shear wave measurements on a stored image? Thanks for the question. So yes, you can pull up a stored shear wave image in exam review, and you can replace the measurement ROI, putting it in a more appropriate place to sample, and update the shear wave worksheet as well. Okay, next. So what do the colors mean in the shear wave propagation map? Great question, thank you. So the colors indicate the propagation direction. And if you're using our default color map, the blues indicate early arrival times, and the red, the later arrival times. So that can help when you're assessing the shear wave quality using our propagation map display. Okay, which transducers support shear wave elastography? We have a variety of transducer options for shear wave on the Aplio i800. There are 6 different convex abdominal transducers. We also have 3 linear array transducers, 11 megahertz linear, 14 megahertz, and an 18 megahertz linear. And then lastly, we do have our endocavitary shear wave capabilities as well, and that's on the PVT781VTE. Now, some of our advanced features for liver analysis, like attenuation imaging and shear wave dispersion, those are on the convex abdominal transducers. So I recommend using the I8CX1 transducer. Thanks so much for your attention. For more information or to schedule a live demonstration in your facility, visit our website, us.medical.canon, or click back into the virtual booth to start a chat session. We have imaging specialists standing by.